And now let us move towards the plenary session number 13 of the schedule. And for this, let me take the privilege to call upon the screen Dr. A.S.A. Firdaus Alam, sir, Assistant Professor, School of International Studies, University Uttara, Malaysia. Dr. Firdaus is an assistant professor of International Business Department, University of Uttara, Malaysia. He is an associate fellow for Center for Sustainability Research and Consultancy. Sir has participated in various conferences at the international and national level. He has published more than 92 research articles, including 42 journal papers in international journals, 41 research papers, and 6 poster magazines in different international journals. His research interests include developmental economics, sustainability of tourism, oil palm and palm oil, disaster management, business management, marketing, and international business, etc. So with this, may I please welcome him on the screen. Welcome, sir, and over to you, sir.
Thank you very much. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Okay, thank you very much, Ravindra Kumar, for your introduction. Is the screen see nicely from my side?
Yes, sir, now we can see it clearly.
Yeah. Okay, all right. Hi, good afternoon. Even here in Malaysia, I'm from Malaysia, it's already evening. It's already evening, near about 5 p.m. So thank you very much. Welcome everyone for international conference. And I think today is the last day for 3-day session. So this conference is all about teaching, learning, and education. And it's my opportunity to say something about education in part of a Malaysian perspective. I would like to say something. I would like to share some of our experience here in the COVID time, how we adjust the system, how we adjust the this is actually not familiar or you not usual, not face-to-face class anymore. We are missing our campus, we are missing our students also missing their friends and their teacher, their campus, their surroundings. So now we can understand what is the difference between the conventional educational system and what is the difference between conventional education system and the online portal like Coursera and other famous portal online education. So many time we take the first call, we take information from the student, how they feel, what kind of problem from student side, what kind of problem faces by lecturer side, what is convenient actually, nobody knows. So we are still trial and error method to check and balance, and we have to continue this educational system. We cannot stop. We cannot stop because of our time is very limited. One semester, very fast, it's gone. So if we stuck somewhere, it would be a huge problem for the current student, for upcoming student. Everybody we are facing, and it will be stucking. It will be a huge problem for society as well. So no way, we have to move even in this pandemic situation. So in this pandemic situation, actually the main problem is we cannot go out due to different country, different time. We have a lockdown, we have a different government order to not to go outside or not to make gathering. We only can do some very limited activities with some procedure. We call it social distancing. We have to wear mask. We have to hand sanitizing every time. And this all procedure we must follow by the instruction from United States. So now World Health Organization, so we have to follow all those things. You can see we are facing a lot of stress. Everybody, we are facing a lot of stress. So main stress during this time is economic crisis. So many people, they are jobless due to economic activities is not going on perfectly. Very limit. Activities is going very limit. In Malaysian perspective, we can see Malaysia is a tourism country. So tourism sector is totally now closed, shut down. Only the few, very limit domestic tourism is open. But the international tourism is totally due to lockdown, due to they block the tourists from outside. It's a common scenario everywhere. Some other country like Singapore, Thailand. So we are facing this kind of problem. So between this, if you are not economic solvency, economically solvency, then other problem will occur. Other problem will consequences come and follow with you. And now we are having online classes. We are having online class. Due to online class, we need IT support, IT facilities. So IT facilities, that means we need some devices like computer, tablet, PC or mobile phone, or main thing is we need internet. We need a strong internet because we are using different video moduling, video conversation. So it use it's consume a lot of byte, a lot of data capacity. We need this strong. Without a strong internet support, we cannot do this. So there are five major impact the COVID. That is, people are infected and dead. Then second one is economic crisis, jobless. Then school close. School close, school, university, all educational institutes close, especially international student. Especially international student, they cannot move. Now they cannot move from their home country to other destination country, other country where they go for their education. For example, Malaysia, so many, they prefer. Now they open very limit, they open to encourage who are essential to come. For example, they need some practical session, or last year student, they need some experiment or field work, something like this. For them, they can come with so many measures, so many precautions, so many measures, and it also affect a huge costing. You have to quarantine. You have to quarantine at hotel. You have to check 2-3 time. You swab test. So many procedures we have to follow. Better not to move if you don't have any urgency. So in this slide you can see university student, international student is drop, shrink is. US 43%, Australia 73%, Malaysia also dropped 40%. So they cannot come to Also, the new student, they cannot enroll for new course or new for PhD or master's, they cannot enroll as a new student. So it is also another effect for economic side. If a student not enrolls for university, his income also drop. So that's why university also having financial problem. So this is overall situation you can see. So there are some challenges, there are some opportunity every time we can get from different situation. So few presenter before, I saw a few presenter already discuss about some opportunity we got during this period of pandemic. There are some challenge also we have faced. So we got some opportunity like quality time at home, but we feel before that quality time at home, but we are always at home, but it also burden us so many extra tasks at a time. So now it's, we cannot say it's a quality time. Everybody have their own task. You have to do wherever you are, at home or at office, it doesn't matter. So as an educational person, we can say we have a KPI, we have to complete all those KPI during end of the year. So our teaching plan we have to fulfill, we have to communication with all the students, we have to complete their course curricula, everything. Then we have to go for publication, we have to go other task as well. So communication in space, enhance IT skill. Of course, now so many people, they need to know how to online class, how to do for online class, or how to go for video recording, or how to contact with a student in different platform. For example, Zoom, Google Meet, this way. Okay, so other thing is you can see the awareness event and fundraising, decrease project, sustainable development goal. Those who have in the different country also is down. And domestic violence and mental stress also increase because people have so many pressure for earning source limit. And then their workload increase so many things, and that's why domestic violence increase as well. Economic distress, jobless, health risk as well, we have high. So what is the opportunities for our educator? We got so many open training, workshop training, different forum we can easily add with different forum to learn so many things. Before COVID, we cannot have this kind of practice. It's not open for all. It must be registered. You have to pay the fees or something like this. Now, so many people, they are doing this thing for charity, some training, open training. So everyone get benefited for this. So different innovative idea also we got. For example, some presenter, they show, okay, YouTube, from YouTube, how we can do, how we can learn better way. So, of course, YouTube is a good source of learning so many things. During my PhD, I learned so many things from YouTube. So we can get different version of our problem. So we can easily adapt with our education system. Digital product for education. So now everything got digital version. For example, online article. We cannot go this time. We cannot go all time in library physically. So we got digital version. And acceptance of hybrid learning. Not all university before they have this kind of practice. For example, hybrid means mixed method, face-to-face class 50%, another 50% is online. So online, for example, our university, University of Uttar Malaysia, we have few courses under MOOC. It's called Massive Open Online Course. So under MOOC is fully online based. The lecturer, they upload all kind of lecture in the portal. Everything is there. So the student just enroll and follow the step. They have different quizzes, different exam module. Everything is there. So now we are habituating with this kind of thing. Okay, then other thing is challenges. You can see preparation for deliveries and as an assessment is increase our workload. We have prepared so many things for assessment. Then some other government suggestion and some other thing is inculcate every subject, one compulsory subject, compulsory co-curriculum, so many things. This is actually depends on different organization, how they focus on this kind of curricular. You need to now, this is the time to change or update or adjust some new assessment with the new curriculum, or you have to update the syllabus as well. Curriculum, all thing need to update. So where is our position? So it depends. You can answer different country, they are following different way. Some country I know they are closed. They don't even open in online because they don't have adequate support. For example, some private university, they may continue online, they may start because they are easily to take any decision. But those who are in government institute, they cannot do without government approval, without government permission. So huge lack of internet facilities and then lack of device. You have device that like a computer, laptop, you need to buy this one expensive. So everybody cannot afford on this. Malaysian perspective on our what we practice. I just share some of things. Teaching and learning from home. Since March 2020, we are going online. Everything we are going online. Virtual classroom. We are going all virtual meeting. Everything to avoid gathering. Because the virus is. What's called, we have to maintain the distance. The World Health Organization suggests us we have to maintain the social distancing to avoid this virus. So that's why government, education ministry, and consult with the health ministry, so they take decision that everything will be go for online system. So teaching and learning process to a virtual platform through online learning from home. So we can see so many things, but initially it's very difficult to familiarization, that means familiarity. So people don't know how to use this, how to use that. So though the new generation, they are very quick learner, they can easily understand, but those who are senior professors, senior lecturer, that is very difficult for us to adapt with this kind of new technology, new thing, new method. So they need basic some device, free internet data, education material, and power guidance of meeting student needs. So the student, if we forced to go for online, we have to provide all these kind of facilities. All these kind of facilities. Sometimes students complain they don't have a laptop. So they are taking class through their handphone. So actually handphone, it's not suitable to get everything. It's a compact thing. So everything we cannot do from the handphone. We must have some laptop at least. So if we force them to go for online class, we must provide all kind of facilities, those who need it. So everyone cannot provide, they are not economically sufficient ability, they don't have. University, they are giving selected people, selected student to support them for some computer, some laptop. And some of internet provider also, they give some data or low cost data or free to the student. So virtual teaching and learning from home require strong support from all community member, not only from teacher, but also parents, guardians, school administrator, and that means the administrator, those who are who can take the decision, motivation to task continues, continue learning, and students progress. So they have to motivate to give all kind of facilities. If they say I don't have this device or I don't have internet, or so it's very difficult to continue. Because we have to 100% confirm that 100% student are in the online class or don't have any problem. Utilization of technological advancement, and they have to give all necessary materials in advance to learn them, to teach them. For example, now we give them a digital print version book, PDF book, for more convenient, easily they can read it, or we can give them a slide, we can give them the notes in advance to prepare them. And it's a challenge, so if they are not in class, we can face to face, we can understand what's the situation of every student, but now in online class sometimes we cannot understood, we cannot capture their intention, what is their situation, unless we take the exam. Distance learning or online learning, not about internet communication, but also blended technology. So you must have everything, training, striving to task several students to apply, okay? Application. Educational application. Now we are habituated, we are already familiar with so many educational technology, educational application. We are doing meeting in Google Meet now, then in our university they subscribe Webex, so all kind of class we are taken through Webex. Some university they prefer Zoom, some others application they use. So we have to habituate, we have to familiar with this for further process. Internet, yes, of course, internet connection is more important. If you don't have internet connection, so other thing is worthless. So you have to confirm on the connection internet. So beside class, we have a WhatsApp group. We have a WhatsApp group, we have some message system. If a student face any problem, so they can go, they can discuss with this WhatsApp group. It's a backup from the, beside the online portal. So finally is assessment plan, reassessment plan. Student reassessment plan. So Before we have 60% coursework, 40% final exam. Now we are going 100%. Most of class, most of courses, we are doing 100% coursework. So we have to reassess. Reassess. For example, assignment, project paper, quizzes, test, midterm, case study, class performance. So we are taking different assessment through this kind of 100% coursework. So they have everything have positive and negative issues. So the assignment, the assessment, sometime we are doing, most of time we are doing online, but we don't know perfectly if they are doing their own or they are taking help from others or they are doing it group work or not. So we don't know. So it depends on the ethical aspect. So we hope all the students are doing by themselves. They understood all. So they are not cheating anything. They are not copy and paste. And sometimes the assignment we are checking through the plagiarism. So all those things is a new norms, but we already habituated already 1 year. We celebrate 1 year of COVID. I think that's all. I would like to share one more thing. Can you see my slide, my screen?
Yeah, sure, sir.
Yeah, this is actually our online portal. Most of university, most of public university, they have their own portal, and we are using this portal, and we have to upload everything before class started. So we have a teaching plan, we have a syllabus, we have we have a reference book, everything we are uploaded. You can see we have 14 weeks class schedule. So every week we are taking 3 hour class. So we give them all kind of slide and supportive document, supportive link, whatever it is. So you can see here, we give one link. We give one link. This link can be YouTube, this link can be any website which is related to their subject, their course. So it's very helpful for them. And now we are provided also the recording version of the class. So several times they are listening, they are watching this thing. So it would be have benefited for them. So we give them everything, assessment, when you have to submit, everything in our portal. Already we have to submit before start the class. We complete everything and we must use from everything we use from this portal. So convenient, all students can access and can take all the notes and everything. We have announcement here. If anything, we can write down here for their announcement. So they can notify. Every student can notify. Though all those have facilities, but we have to support. We have to take other for robustness. We have to take other measurement, necessary measure. For example, WhatsApp group. For easy communication nowadays. So we have WhatsApp group. We create WhatsApp group before we start a class. So all kind of notification, instruction, sharing material, everything also we go for WhatsApp group. And this is online portal. We have to prove ourselves in the system that we are following everything perfectly. So we have one system is we are doing everything. We have a blending learning system. So we are doing everything in blended way or not. Blended way or not. So the system is measuring us. And the system is measuring us, how many resources we uploaded, how many activities we are doing, how many assessment we are doing. So if we are doing not perfectly assigned, so it will not blend it. So the university authority told us, okay, you are not doing this. That means this is one kind of auditing. You are not following perfectly. You are not teaching perfectly in assigned to you. So they are checking us. This is auto auditing. So we have to focus on it. Okay, that's all for my side. I think no more sharing. That's all. It's a real sharing from my side. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Firdaus Alam, sir, for such a wonderful and enriching lecture. And your each word was full of information and wisdom, and we are very obliged with your such a wonderful lecture. Thank you so much, sir. And let me open the platform for the open discussion. So if there are any questions from the audience, they can ask. So any questions from the audience side? Hurry up, please, because we are already running short of time.
Yeah, please, if you have any question, we can discuss on it. I think no question, everyone.
I think no question here means that everybody is so much, benefited by your words that they have not even a single doubt in their minds and any kind of question in their mind. So I think it's a good indication that how beautifully you have made us understand. And thank you so much, sir, for such a wonderful lecture and for giving your patience.
My pleasure.
Thank you so much.